Hi, in this video I have prepared two multiple choice questions for you, and this is very easy questions, so I hope everyone would be able to answer both questions correctly, and I recommend you to stop video here, read the questions, answers, try to choose the correct answer, and when you would be ready, you can run video again and you can compare your answer with my answer and explanation. So here is the first question. Pea plants were particularly well suited for use in Mendel's breeding experiments for all of the following reasons, except that answer A. Peas show easily observed variations in number of characters such as pea shape and flower color, and this is true. And answer B. It is possible to completely control matings between different pea plants. And this is also true. Answer C. It is possible to obtain large numbers of the progeny from any given cross. And now we left with two answers. Answer D. Peas have an unusually long generation time. And answer E. Many of the observable characteristics that vary in pea plants are controlled by single genes. And this is true, and what is not true is answer D. Peas have an unusually long generation time, and this is not true, because the generation time is rather short. The whole life cycle can be during the summer. Sometimes you even can get to harvest during summer, and this depends on the cultivar. So the correct answer would be D. And the second question, a plant with purple flowers is allowed to self-pollinate, and generation after generation it produces purple flowers. And this is an example of, and here is the five answers to choose from. And answer A, hybridization. Answer B, incomplete dominance. C, true breeding. D, the law of segregation. And answer E, polygenetics, and the correct answer would be answer C. This is example of true breeding. Imagine when the situation when we have parent 1 and parent 2, and parent 1 would be heterozygous, and parent 2 also would be heterozygous, and if we build a Punnett square, we would see that here would be genotype capital P, and here capital P small p, and capital P small p here, and small p here. So as you see, if capital P would stand for the purple, and small p, for example, for the white color, we would have here segregation, and 1 out of 4 would be white colored, and 3 out of 4 would be purple colored. And this would be example of segregation of two alleles. And there is also can be different situation when parent 1 and parent 2 can be homozygous dominant for the same allele. And in this case, if we build a Punnett square, we would see that only one genotype and one phenotype possible here. So all the plants would have genotype that is capital P, and one phenotype that is purple. And if you cross this progeny or self-pollinate, you always only can get purple flowers. And this trait wouldn't segregate, as in this example, to purple and white colored plants. So such genotype we would call true breeding. And this can be true breeding, for example, for purple color, or if each parent would be, parent 1, for example, would have homozygous recessive genotype, so small p and parent 2 also would have homozygous recessive genotype small p. Of course, such plants would be true breeding for the white color. So, this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments if you have any. Goodbye.